you can do at home in 20 minutes.
All you're gonna need is a single dumbbell, 5 exercises, 15 reps. Are you ready to get after it?
Let's do it.
Let's go after it. All right, we're gonna start with the biggest muscle group to start to torch all of that calories off your body, your goblet squats. Single dumbbell needed. Take a look at what this looks like. Like you're holding a goblet right in front of your chest, you're gonna set your feet about hip, shoulder width apart. Descend into a deep squat, push those knees out, and drive up strong. Always slow on the negative 1, 2, with a strong count on the positives. Keep your chest up, and why I love the goblet squat is that it auto-corrects your form. That load in front of your chest keeps your body upright. One detail on this, what I want you to focus on every single time at the top, squeeze the quads, squeeze the booty at the top, that finishes the move, no halfsies. Full range of motion. How those legs feeling?
They're feeling it.
A little bit on fire. Oh, let it burn. Give me 5 more on this squat. If you're feeling good, if your body takes you there, drop it down another inch, get that range of motion. Ooh, 2 more. Deep. 1 more, explosive on the way up. Ah, that's your goblet squat. Ooh. If your legs were on fire with the goblet squat, it's okay. We're gonna take the lactic acid out of the legs into the upper body core with a plank exchange. Take a look. It starts in a high plank. Set your hands underneath the shoulders, set your feet about shoulder width apart. Here's the details. Lock out the knees, squeeze the quads, squeeze the glutes, so you can really lock in your hip. And we're gonna travel that bell 15 times. No bueno! If you're swaying all over the place, so keep that hip locked in. Push-up position. Locked in, and in 3, 2, 1, give me 15. Core intensive, at its finest. You're gonna travel that bell, keep that hip locked in. Remember, the knees should be completely locked out. If you squeeze your glutes, you'll feel your hip tuck in. Keep it tight. Your abs on the whole time. Tuck them in, supporting the lower back. And your head, keep your head nice and in line. Give me 6 more on the 6 string. 6 strong. Don't you dare drop it yet. Good. It's challenging about your 10th rep. We're gonna rock out 4 more. Nice and okay. 2 more. And last one. Plank dumbbell exchange. All right, back to the legs with the lateral lunge shift. I love this one. Send the feet wide. Keep that bell right in front of your chest. We're gonna work the side of the booty with this movement, side to side, hip back, chest up, squeezing everything. 3, 2, 1, good. Same rules apply, like the squat. You want a little bit more weight through the heels. You wanna keep that knee pushed out just a little bit more. And again, I love holding a bell in front of your chest because it auto-corrects your form. It keeps your upper body upright the whole time. If you're feeling good, go ahead and drop it down a little deeper. Give me 4 more with this movement. 4, 3, 2, and 1 more to cap it off. Ooh, those legs. If your heart is beating off your chest, that just means you're alive. Let's take it back to the upper body with the bent over row. In a long stance, take a look. Get a 90-degree angle on that front leg. I'm gonna take my forearm and rest it there. Even in this position, I can find a tall, neutral spine. I'll lift through the elbows, and we'll work that backside. Keep the shoulder down. Bring the dumbbell right to the rib cage, and always control it on the negative. Sound good? Let's get into that position, lock it in, and in 3, 2, 1, let's rock out 15. Now, you build a lot of strength, a lot of muscle on the negative, on the way down. So, don't rush it. 1 count up, 2 counts on the negative. If you feel like it's getting into your neck, that means you're shrugging your shoulders. So keep your shoulder down, away from the ear. Control gravity on that negative. Give me 5 more. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Got to show the other side some love. Flip it. Right foot in front. Good 90-degree angle. Forearm down. Let's rock it out. Bring that bell to the side of the rib cage. I want you to open up that shoulder blade, work that side. Let's get a strong back. And on the floor and hit the midsection in the major way with a double crunch. Take a look. One key secret to this movement, you want to keep your lower back pressed on the ground the whole time. So I'm going to start in this position here with the knees tucked and the dumbbell right in front of your chest. You're going to extend the arms as you're extending the dumbbell up, and then I'm going to crunch at the top. Nice and easy to start. And if you feel good about it, your body takes you there. You can slowly extend the legs and extend that dumbbell up even more. If you lift and raise that dumbbell up overhead, your lower back is going to want to rise off the ground. Your challenge, keep the core on the whole time by using your abdominal strength to press that lower back. Keep it glued on the floor. Whew. Abs are starting to feel it right now. Let it burn. You need five more. Five, four, three, two more to cap it off. Two, and squeeze the juices out of that midsection. One. How you feeling?
Feel it.
Good. And those were your five exercises. Here's the deal. Five exercises, 15 repetitions apiece. I want you to go for three total rounds. Maybe take a minute at the most. Break, rest in between round. But if you want to make 2018 your best year ever, beast it out and go for five total rounds. I'll never hold you back. I have had a ton of fun, Emma. Thank you.
This was amazing and really intense. You guys have to try it at home.
I think we're pretty good.
All right, we're on it. Like at the end, we can have just like,
this will be like the end, like the outro.
Yeah. I'm being double though, we're not being able to breathe. Really good shape, guys. We're totally good. Oh my god.